In 2014, a volcano in Indonesia produced a violently explosive eruption, causing its edifice to change from this to this. As a result, 7 fatalities occurred alongside significant disruptions to the local economy. This occurred at the Kelud volcano, which since the year 1900 has produced 4 other eruptions of a similar size. Yes, it is true that Indonesia not only contains the highest number of actively erupting volcanoes in the planet, but also the highest number of volcanoes which have caused fatalities. And yet, while Indonesian volcanoes such as Tambora, Krakatoa, and Merapi are well known due to their past deadly eruptions, for some reason Kelud is not as well known despite how dangerous this particular volcano really is. Since record-keeping began in the 1500s, Kelud has produced 10 separate eruptions that resulted in fatalities, totaling 15,446 people. For example, Kelud's eruption in 1919 killed 5,110 people, its 1966 eruption killed 215, and its 1990 eruption killed 39. Almost all of these deaths occurred due to the very same geologic hazard, Lahars. In other words, long-reaching volcanic mud flows that move at high speeds that can easily overtop drainages in riverbanks, which behave like wet concrete and are overall responsible for just about 1 out of every 5 volcano deaths worldwide. Kelud's deadliest such lahar in 1586 caused 10,000 fatalities when a wall of material plowed through the town of Blitar, leaving behind a 1.5 meter or 5 foot thick wall of mud. For reference, this town is 24 kilometers or 15 miles away from Kelud's summit. It is for this very reason that among all more than 1,000 active or potentially active world volcanoes, I rank Kelud as the 15th most potentially dangerous volcano. Yet, there is some good news which should make future eruptions of Kelud cause significantly fewer casualties. And this comes back to why its unusually voluminous lahars have occurred in the past. You see, Kelud's summit crater is vast and deep, meaning it can theoretically hold more than 200 million cubic meters of water. During past eruptions, some or all of this has been violently released in multiple directions. Thankfully, after the 1966 eruption, the government built a series of tunnels called the Impera tunnels to drastically reduce the level of water present in the volcano's central crater. Although it has needed repair after every large eruption, its implementation has been a huge success which saved countless lives via keeping the crater lake volume at 2 million cubic meters or less at all times. Already, these tunnels have saved what I estimate to be 15,000 lives that otherwise would have been lost in post-1966 eruptions. However, this success has still not stopped all lahar deaths from occurring, as volcanic ashfall and pyroclastic flow deposits both inside and outside of a main crater, and the up to 2 million cubic meters of material can still theoretically combine to create a sizable series of lahars. It is for this reason best to avoid, in the opinion of Geology Hub, any area, especially drainages and low points, within at least 10 kilometers of Kelud's summit when it is actively producing a large eruption or has a high chance of soon producing a major eruption. Now, more about the overall volcano. The Kelud stratovolcano is located within Indonesia where it is on the south-central section of the island of Java. Specifically, it is 35 kilometers west of the city of Malang. From ground level, Kelud is not as prominent as several of its neighboring volcanoes such as Bromo and Semeru. Compared to the aforementioned 2 volcanoes, it has a much older appearance containing dozens of deeply dissected valleys which are consistent with much higher levels of erosion. However, this volcano in all likelihood is much younger but has produced more frequent large-scale lahars and eruptions than its counterparts, which are the cause of its deeply dissected valleys. Thus, Kelud may be as young as 45,000 years old. Regardless, many eruptions built this deeply eroded volcano out of primarily basaltic andesite and andesite lava and ash, largely through Vulcanian and Subplanian-Deplanian eruptions. The latter of these occurred due to a fairly repetitive process of lava dome growth, the lava dome plugging building pressure before violently being ejected in a massive explosion which capped the circular nature of the summit crater. These generate pyroclastic flows, which scorched an area of 26.6 square kilometers during its 2014 eruption. During the last 1,000 years, Kelud has erupted about once every 29 years, although only 8 of these eruptions were similar in size to its 2014 eruption. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube for supporting my work.